feel it. Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's weird that, like, this whole, like, Drag Race thing and, like, how people can recognize me and stuff like that? And, like, airports and stuff, you don't find that weird?
I don't know. I don't think it's weird. I mean, it's expected. You worked hard. You know, for, I don't expect anything less. I didn't expect anything less.
I wonder what mom would have thought.
She'd get mad at you for buying stuff for her, paying for her to go places. She'd hate it.
I don't know. I still don't have, like, full closure with her.
Yeah, I don't either, obviously. But, I mean...
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, the deal is, I mean, it's like... Because of his sexuality, and she never really, you never really got that acceptance from her in a good state of mind.
I think that, and I think, like, yeah, like, because when, like, she was dying, like, mm-hmm. she told me, you know, she didn't agree with it, and we got into fights about it, and I remember one conversation we had, like, where I told her, you know, look, if you don't at least accept it, you don't have to like it, but you have to accept it, the fact that I am gay, mm-hmm. you're going to lose a son. Since I can remember, there has always been struggles in my life to overcome. The older I get, the more I realize I can handle those struggles. They've made me who I am today. My name is Ryan Taylor, but you may know me as Trinity the Tuck.
Small town in Alabama. It was nothing but cow fields and grass and trees. I grew up in a trailer and I really didn't know much of what my future was going to hold. I was always told I was never tall enough or big enough or good enough or cute enough. I got into high school and I discovered art. I figured I could paint. I got a little older and I found drag and I knew that this is where I wanted to be. I came with my drag mother, Jordan Kennedy, to this system in 2004 and I fell in love. This is where I've grown up as an entertainer. This is who I am as an entertainer. If it was not for this system, the people that I've met through this system, you guys, the judges, I would not be who I am today, not just as an entertainer, but as a person. You know it's important to you when you take things personal when it comes to here. And I want you to know, I love you guys, and no matter what, this is my home. And I would love nothing more than to be National Entertainer of the Year.
Thank you.
turtles, stingrays, whales, and golden wallaby. All equipment and light breakfast provided. Free surfers. Okay, I need to remember that. Whale watching. Fine for Australian kayaking adventure. I'm gonna go swim with the fish. Like, I wanna do like snorkeling, but not just like above the water. I always wanted to get my nose done for a lot of reasons, because I was always really made fun of as a kid, for having like a big nose, and out of anything that I've ever had that has been an insecurity, it's probably like my number one thing. I think, you know, obviously, like, as you get older, you kind of, like, accept the flaws that you have. And I have accepted the fact that I have a big nose and that it's not, like, a perfect nose. But now that, you know, I'm in a place where I can financially do that, I want to change it. I want to have the nose that I want. Not because I can't deal with it or whatever, or that it's going to make me, like, super confident or something. It's more like, you know, something I want to do for myself. Plus, I love plastic surgery.
Well, you are the plastic queen.
Well, you know, it's on brand.
You're so stupid.
Is this thing supposed to be out here? Is this thing supposed to be loose?
Hello, there's something over here in the weeds.
There's something in the woods.
Oh my gosh.
That's you.
That is the bird. Did we get
it? Okay, I'll go down and check. Can I go down and check?
It's a big one. Where are they? I can't go back now.
I think you can see here, around.
I think it's half of its tail's chopped off.
Pretty.
Look at this
cockatoo. Oh my god, we're gonna go pet koalas!
Going from virtually unknown to having fans around the world is quite strange for me. I am still adapting to figure out how to fully act around people who are super excited to see me and meet me for the first time.
The one whose name is Trinity Taylor, I think.
I think she might be called Trinity the Tuck Taylor.
Right. Apparently she's known for how flat her tuck is, whatever that means.
One thing I do know is that I'm very grateful to have people who appreciate my story. They've somehow connected with my story, and it's brought joy to their life, or it's made them think a little harder about their life, or it's got them through their own struggles, and that makes me very happy. My fans really make me appreciate even more the blessings that I have been given. And, you know, I truly hope that I'd never disappoint.
Honestly, I don't think I would change anything. I think everything happens for a reason, and you have to embrace your mistakes
and celebrate your successes, and here I am. If I changed something, then maybe I wouldn't be where I'm at.
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
I know.
exactly. Well, in another 10 years, you won't remember either. I'll have a nose that, you know. You change your boobs. That's not what I remember. You change your hair color all the time. You got Botox?
So did you. First. Don't make me smile on myself.
Are you excited about going snorkeling here? Looking back on my tumultuous relationship with my grandmother, I wonder often how she would feel about me today. I kind of think that when I had that interview with RuPaul and she said that she thought my grandmother would be proud of me, it made me think, and I agree. I think that in the end, things that are not in someone's comfort zone, it takes them a minute to process and become okay with. And I think that after a while, my grandmother would have come to terms with the fact that I'm gay and would have looked at the bigger picture and realized how much of an impact drag has made on me in a positive way for my future. And I really do think that she would be proud of me. She doesn't fit. My bags are heavy, so I'm leaving you a gift. Have fun. Pictures of Maggie the other day made me really miss her. Not the pictures,
the video.
Yeah, seeing the video of Maggie the other day made me miss her. I really miss Ludo too, because he's getting so big and he's learning those tricks and I'm not there to see. And I miss Gizzy. City in the world, Perth. Australia, how people got here is beyond me. I also learned that they don't necessarily teach history here. It's optional. Shows every day except for two is a lot. It's been obviously worth it. We've got to experience a lot of things in Australia. The fans have been amazing. The venues have been great. The promoters have been great. But it's exhausting. But this is what I signed up for. I mean, I wouldn't have it any other way. Merry Christmas to Merry Crystal.
Merry Christmas, Maggie.
It's so weird to have Christmas and cooking for Christmas. Going over to family's house. Haven't celebrated Christmas in 3 years. So this is fun. You know, being single is not all what it's cracked up to be.
It isn't, Maggie. It isn't.
And I have, like, no motivation to, like, buy presents or put up Christmas trees or anything. But, you know, this is a good year. This is a special year. I'm in a relationship, and I'm close to Leo's family. They're like my family. So it's nice. Merry Christmas.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a drag queen Christmas! Please welcome to the stage your host for this evening, the one and only Trinity Taylor!
Trump is our president. Like, it is laughable. and the things that have been happening in this country that he's able to get away with is insane. If you look at what's going on in the world, there are tons more white, straight men in power who are taking advantage of children, of men and women, and getting away with it. I do think, though, even with the ridiculousness that's at hand, I do feel very positive for the future.
Look around you. Make sure you have your flashlight on your phone, looking at somebody's face before you take them home, because y'all are some ugly motherfuckers. I'm from Alabama. I thought we were bad. But you know what? Actually, I'm kind of proud of Alabama these days, bitch. Come on, Alabama. Who would have thought? A Democrat. I can't believe it. But you know what it is, though? What it is? My black folks. And not just my black folks, but more importantly, my strong black women folks. I feel like there's a revolution coming on, bitch. Women are feeling themselves and they're following their voices, and it's important for you guys to do the same. Not just women, but everyone. It's your job to go out and vote, not just for the president, but your local government. It really does make a difference. And thank you so much, Alabama. You didn't elect a horrible pervert like me.
Happy New Year!
Are you excited about your surgery in 2 days?
I'm definitely excited. I'm kind of nervous, not to go under or anything, but more so like to make sure he does what I want him to do. I don't want him to be too conservative. I want this thing chopped off. I don't want it to, you know, I don't want to have to come get it done again. But I'm very excited. This is something I've wanted my entire life.
But yeah, let's hope for the best.
Girl, thank God I shaved my legs as fast as I did in 3 minutes. Because I could not find my tights. And a bitch was hairy. Talk about wildebeest.
Actually parked around back. I was just waiting a few more minutes before I came in because y'all said to be exactly on time, so. Okay, all right, we'll be in. Thank you, bye.
Second floor.
My hair's a mess.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Michael. Call me Dr. Miami. I'm a plastic surgeon, and I make people feel better about their bodies. Watch me as I snatch out my way through Tuesday.
Why?
great dream.
What was it?
Puppy wasn't too conservative.
No, you see a difference. I mean, you're swollen right now, but you definitely see a difference when I take a pill. Remember, the tip is what takes the longest to see the results in, so don't panic. It's going to be swollen the longest.
Here's a needle in my arm.
It's coming out. Do you want to laugh? It's actually plastic.
The needle is plastic?
Yeah, everybody thinks it's like a metal needle. It's not.
It's a plastic needle in my arm?
Yep. It's out. Look, plastic.
What?
Yep.
We could find like a good male
pajama set.
So I had to go get a woman.
It looks comfortable though.
And it doesn't look like two women.
Not that I care.
You see, is that really concerning for you?
No.
Yay.
Bye, babe.
Oh,
bye.
Done. Bianca just sent me a text message. It says, checking in, how are you doing, lady? And then I responded to her, I'm good. I don't feel any pain, how are you? And she says, I'm good. Just wanted to make sure you're okay. If you need drugs, I'll smuggle them in Jiggly's ass. Hey, you need to go skydiving tomorrow? Through all these old photos of like my childhood and my family, because I haven't seen these in forever. I haven't looked through these in a while. That was my family. Me, my grandmother, my grandfather, my sister. Ooh, look at those. Early drag. That face. Ooh. Way. Some of these pictures. Oh my gosh, before any face work. Look at that. Wow. Oh, this was my first time ever in drag. I did a womanless beauty pageant for a fundraiser for my high school, and I was Shanae Candy. I used water balloons for my boobs, and my little cousin did my makeup. It was terrible.
So I think we're gonna go to Spring Bowl to see my hometown. I haven't been there in a couple of years, actually. I don't know what's changed, but I know that I haven't been to my grandparents' grave since they were buried, so we're gonna do that today too. I've gotta go buy flowers. So that should be interesting. This journey of accepting myself for however way I want to accept myself has been a challenge, but I've realized as I've gotten older, no matter if I alter something about what I look like or don't, or the fact that I never got full closure with my grandmother, that I, in the end, have to accept and love myself. And I think that I'm finally okay with that. I'm finally coming to terms, and I'm at peace with my grandmother. I'm excited that I can finally just be happy and be me and be happy being me. And that's what life's about.